Brokerages are body shops, and they aren't there to train you, the agent. This is the Get Your Ass to Work podcast, episode number 55. We are talking about brokerages aren't really there to provide you the best training to make sure that you are successful. Why is this? It's really simple. There are a certain number of bodies that they need coming in the door to match the number of bodies going out the door in order to make the brokerage work. Is this right or wrong? It's neither. It's just what it is. And a lot of agents think that the brokerage is responsible for training you and they're responsible for making sure you're successful and giving you leads and all this other bullshit, and they just aren't. The problem is that brokerages make people think that is what they are there to do. And what they really do is they train agents on how to keep the brokerage out of trouble. So they go over all this stuff that doesn't really matter, like contracts and how to do shit, like set up your website and get your cards made and all this stuff that isn't actually going to bring you business. But agents think that is what is going to bring them business. Oh, I need my website set up. I need my business cards made. And yes, you do need all that stuff, but that's not what really brings you business. But that is the lie. That is the stretching of the truth. That is the bullshit that the brokerages tell agents in order to get them to join. And then once they join, you're kind of on your own. And why is that? Well, it's really simple. It is like that because you, as an agent, are an independent contractor. And what that means is that you are not able to be told what to do. You can't be told when you have to come into work. You can't be told how to do your job. And it is not up to the brokerage to hold you accountable to make sure that you are successful. So how invested are they going to be in training you and providing all of this valuable training so that you can go out and make millions of dollars in real estate when they can't even get you in line? They can't even rein you in when you start drifting off and not doing your work and fucking off and going out on vacations and not making the brokerage any money. Well, they can't, which is one of the beautiful parts of real estate, but it's also one of the bullshit lies that brokerages tell agents of all these things that they're going to help the agents do. We're going to help you be successful. We're going to help you do this. We have the best training, except that's not what really happens. It's just not. I've seen it in a lot of brokerages, and I've heard the complaints from new agents. Now, you're an independent contractor. Here's the truth. You are responsible for the education that you are going to need to be successful in real estate. You are successful. It is not up to the brokerage to make sure that you are successful. You are an independent contractor. So I've made a list of some things that you are responsible for to make sure that you learn so that you can go out and be successful. Now, you can write this off. You can tell me I'm crazy. You can say, oh, but I never had to do any of that. All right, we'll get to all those points in a minute. Let's just be clear. If you are relying on your brokerage to help make sure that you are successful, if you have blamed your brokerage for you not having any deals, it is your fucking fault. It is up to you. And if you didn't know before then, now you know. And now that you know, it's time to do something about it. So we're going to cover 5 points of the most important aspects that you need to know to get into business, start making money, and not ever, ever, ever be reliant on a brokerage, be reliant on buying buyer leads, being reliant on a team giving you business, and all of this other Mickey Mouse bullshit that a lot of brokerages push. We're about to cover the items that you need to know to go out and be successful without anybody's help, but it is all up to you. This is what you need to learn. Number one, you need to learn a schedule / time management. You need to know exactly what you're doing every single minute of the day. Let me make this as clear as fucking possible, as easy as fucking possible. If you're a new agent, here's what you need to be doing. You need to be in the office doing lead generation from 8 to 12 o'clock without fail, no matter fucking what. Appointments are from 12 o'clock until 6 or 7 o'clock or whenever you have to go pick up your kids from school or whatever else you have to do. Your appointments are for the afternoon. Your lead generation gets done first fucking thing every day. Not answering emails, not responding to an appraiser who's having a meltdown, not looking at what fucked up things happened on an inspection report and panicking and calling the title agent at 9:01 because they just opened and you're not doing your lead generation. Your job is to do your lead generation from 8 to 12, no matter fucking what, and everything else can wait until noon. Number two, lead generation. You have to learn this. You have to learn this. You have to learn lead generation. I don't care what kind of lead generation you do. Dan, I'm not going to make cold calls. I'm not going to call expireds. Great. Then you need to get really, really, really fucking good at doing 4 hours of writing note cards every day and touching people in your sphere of influence and calling friends and family and past clients and making sure that you have 4 hours worth of work that you can do each and every single fucking day, Monday through Friday, of lead generation. If you don't have 4 hours to do, which you won't, which you fucking won't, you better start calling neighbors. You better start cold calling. You better start knocking doors, holding open houses between 8 and 12 every fucking day to make sure you are doing some form of lead generation. You have to learn this. You have to master that. Otherwise, you are always going to be wondering where your next deal is going to come from. You are always going to be waiting for a referral to come in from a friend or family member, which it may come in or it may not. It may be a referral for a condo at $80,000. It may be a $900,000 home. You'll never fucking know because it's a referral. You're not in control. And then you need to learn lead follow-up and how to work your database. Your database is your fucking gold mine. Your database, start with this. Get a database. Move on to this. Start looking at your database every day. Just doing that, just looking at your database daily is going to cause you to get more deals without a fucking doubt. Why? Because you're going to open your database. Just look at it. Just look at the people in there. And it is going to remind you of somebody you need to fucking call. And you're going to make a call and you're going to get more deals just by looking at your database, let alone learning how to actually systematize your database and fucking work it properly. Just open your database. Start with that and go advanced. Learn how to set up campaigns of not drip campaigns. Nobody likes to be dripped on, not emails and bullshit, of an actual campaign of items of value. We're not going into that today. That's what you need to learn. It is very easy. There's 1,000,010 fucking videos on YouTube that can teach you guys how to do this shit. Next, listing appointments. You have to know how to go on a listing appointment. You have to know how to win on a competitive listing appointment. I've heard a lot of people that don't want to prospect. They don't want to make calls to expireds. And really, they don't want to go on a listing appointment where they have to compete. They don't want to be in a competitive listing appointment where they might lose and it might hurt their little ego. And they might get chosen for a reason where, say, the other agent was just not doing something right and, well, we're going to give you a shot, but you have to cut down your commission. People don't want to have to negotiate. People don't want to have to go into these awkward situations with people that they don't know. So they only work on referral, and that's cool. You know, that's cool to work on referral. But you have to learn how to go on these competitive listing appointments. You have to learn. If you don't, you are always going to have a leg down on the rest of the marketplace. You are always going to be waiting for that perfect referral to come in. You're never going to get after it and go chase business because you're scared. You don't want to deal with that shit. You don't want to call an expired and be told no and have your little ego hurt. I get it. It sucks. It's not fun. But you got to be willing to get kicked in the teeth in order to get ahead. It's just the bottom line. Guys, these five items that we just talked about are exactly what brokerages are not teaching. They are not teaching this. They are not teaching lead generation at a high level. They are not teaching pre-qualification of a lead. They are not teaching your pre-listing packet. They are not teaching how to go out and win on a competitive listing appointment. You may be able to take a class. You may have a class that you take for a week or 2 weeks or whatever, for a day. You might be able to pay for something. But the truth is your responsibility is to go educate yourself on how to be successful in real estate. That's what you need to fucking learn. The rest of it, if you learn how to lead generate, produce your own business, and take a listing, guys, if you can do that, you fucking won. You will do what probably 50% of real estate agents who are making any money in the business at all are afraid to do. You're probably in the top 10% of all of the real estate agents in whatever marketplace you're in, because most people will never lead generate. They will never make a cold call. They will never go on competitive listing appointments. And you will have that advantage in your pocket, and you'll be able to use it and take listings at will when you want. You want to make more money, you know what you have to do. That's the game. That's what real estate is. It is taking listings and lead generating. The rest of it is pretty much not important. Notice I didn't say spend time setting up your website. Notice I didn't say networking events with lenders and title companies. It's a waste of fucking time. Not 100%. I'm just saying, when you need to get going and you need to be doing shit, and you've got those brand new title reps who are like, oh, you're new to the business, let me take you out to lunch. It's a waste of your fucking time. You need to be lead generating. You need to be making cold calls, knocking on doors, and getting out there and getting after it. So, guys, these are the items that matter. Your broker isn't going to hold your hand and teach you this shit. And if they did, that's fucking awesome. If your broker is one of the few that actually did that, I'm sure there's going to be somebody who's like, oh, I'm a broker and I did this for one or two people. Okay, brokers at a mass scale, they don't do this shit. You are a body and you are a number and you are in or you are out, and they are depending. They have a system in place to replace you as soon as you decide to leave, and they count on that system to just replace you. And you're an independent contractor. They can't hold you accountable. This is the reason why it's up to you. 100% take responsibility for your own production. Take responsibility for your own education. Take responsibility for you either making money or not making any money, but know that it's all in your hands, because it is. We'll see you guys next week.